गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न प्रोपोर्शन. ओके, एज यू कैन सी क्लियरली, सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ प्रोपोर्शन? व्हेन टू रेशियोज आर इक्वल देन दे आर सेड टू बी इन प्रोपोर्शन. मीन्स इफ पी क्यू आर एंड एस आर सच दैट पी इज टू क्यू equals to R is to S, then we say that P, Q, R and S are in proportion. The numbers used in proportion are called its terms. Okay, the number which we use in proportion are called its terms, where P is the first term, Q is the second term, R is the third term and S is the fourth term. Also, the first and fourth terms are known as extreme terms. I am repeating this again. The first and fourth terms are known as extreme terms and the second and third terms are known as mean terms. Proportion is denoted by the symbol this. Okay. If this symbol is given, it denotes that all the four numbers, that is P is to Q equals to R is to S. Okay. And is read as P is to Q as R is to S. It is not necessary that all the four quantities forming a proportion are of same kind, and it is also not necessary that all the four quantities forming a proportion are of the same kind. The first two quantities must be of the same kind. Okay, the first two quantities must be of the same kind and the last two quantities must be of the same kind. For example, 3 meter, 5 meter, 18 second, 30 second are in proportion because 3 is to 5 equals to 18 is to 30. Okay. Now let us see one example. Check whether the two ratios form a proportion or not. Okay. You have to check whether these two ratios are in proportion or not. How? Since 1 is to 7 equals to 1 by 7 and 5 is to 7 equals to 5 by 7. Now we cannot reduce these fractions into lowest term, okay, because it is already in lowest term. So 1 is to 7 is not equal to 5 is to 7 and hence they do not form a proportion. Okay, now come to question number B. Since 15 is to 24 equals to 15 by 24 and when we reduce these terms we get 5 by 8. Okay, again 10 is to 16. When we reduce this 10 is to 16, we get 5 by 8. So we can say that 15 is to 24 equals to 10 is to 16. And hence, they form a proportion. Okay. So students, in exercise 8.2, question number 1, you have to follow this method and you have to write whether the given are in proportion, means true or false. Okay. Now, let us start exercise 8.2, question number 2. Okay students, now let us start exercise 8.2. Okay, question number 2. Determine x if 72 is to 112 is proportional to x is to 28. This means this is proportional to this. Okay. Now how to find the value x? The numbers 72, 112, x and 28 are in proportion. Okay. That is 72 is to 112 equals to x is to 28. Now we solve it. 72 by 112 equals to x by 28. Now we cross multiply. We leave the x here and we move this 28 to here. Okay. That means 72 into 28 divided by 112. After reducing, we get the answer 18. So the value of x will be, here you can write. So the value of x equals to 18. So students, you can solve this problem in this way. Okay. Now let us move to next question.
Okay, students, now let us move to question number 4. But before starting question number 4, let me tell you that you can solve question number 3 by your own, because it is similar to question number 2. Okay, now let us start question number 4. The question is, in a proportion, the first, second and fourth terms are 3, 5 and 25 respectively. Find the third term. So, as you can see, first, second and fourth terms are given. You have to find the third term. So, let the third term be x. The numbers 3, 5, x and 25 are in proportion. It is already given in the book, in your question. That is, 3 is to 5 equals to x is to 25. Now, let us solve this question. 3 by 5 equals to x by 25. Okay? We leave the x here and we just do the cross multiply. 25 into 3 divided by 5. After solving this, we get the answer 15. So, 15 equals to x. Therefore, the third number is 15. Or you can say, the third term is 15. Okay? Now, students, let us move to next exercise.
Okay, students, now let us start new topics, unitary method. In unitary method, the value of a unit quantity is obtained first to find the value of the required quantity. The basic principle of unitary method is to divide to get less and multiply to get more. For example, if the price of 5 books is given as rupees 335, and we wish to find the price of 7 books, we divide to get the price of 1 book, which is rupees 335 by 5 equals to rupees 67. So the price of 7 books equals to 67 into 7 equals to rupees 469. So in simpler way, students, you have to understand that if suppose that price of 5 books is given, okay. Now, it is asked to find the price of 7 books. What you have to do? You have to simply find the price of 1 book. How you can find the price of 1 book? By dividing this amount with 5. You get the price of 1 book equals to rupees 67. Okay. Now, when you get the price of 1 book, you can easily find the price of 7 books, 8 books or 10 books. So here it is asked to find the price of 7 books. So the price of 7 books is rupees 67 into 7 equals to rupees 469. Okay. Now come to variation. Variation means change in one quantity with respect to the other quantity. While using unitary method, we will come across two types of variations. When we use unitary method, we come across two types of variations. One is direct variation, another is inverse variation. So what is direct variation? Two quantities are said to be in direct variation if an increase or decrease in one quantity causes a corresponding increase or decrease in the other quantity. Did you understand? Two quantities are said to be in direct variation if an increase or decrease in one quantity causes a corresponding increase or decrease in the other quantity. For example, if 5 pencils can be bought with rupees 20, okay, cost of 5 pencils equals to rupees 20, then cost of 10 pencils can be bought with rupees 40. So, thus more is the amount of money, more is the number of pencils. So, number of pencils and amount of money are in direct variation. Now, let us move to inverse variation. Two quantities are said to be in inverse variation if an increase or decrease in one quantity causes a corresponding decrease or increase. If it is increased, then other is decreased. If it is decreased, other is increased. Okay. For example, if 5 men can complete a work in 8 days, then 1 man will complete the same work in 5 into 8 equals to 40. So thus, lesser the number of men to complete the work, more is the number of days required. Okay. So, number of men and number of days are in inverse variation. Okay, students. So now you have to complete exercise 8.3.
Okay, students. Now let us start exercise 8.3. Okay. In exercise 8.3, we have 8 questions. Okay. And few questions are of direct variation and few questions are of inverse variation. So now let us start with question number 1. If the cost of 6 soaps is rupees 54, find the cost of 10 such soaps. Okay, students. Now as you can see the question, that we have the cost of 6 soaps equals to 54, equals to rupees 54, and then we have to find the cost of 10 such soaps. Okay, so by this question we can understand that this is direct variation. Why direct variation? Because as the number of soaps increase, the amount also increases. If the number of soaps decrease, the amount also decreases. Now let us solve this question. Cost of 6 soaps equals to rupees 54. Okay. Now cost of 1 soap equals to rupees 54 divided by 6, and we get the answer 9. Okay. As you can see, the number of soap is reduced, amount is also reduced. Okay. Now we have found the amount, or you can say cost of 1 soap, that is rupees 9. Now we have to find the cost of 10 such soaps. What we have to do? Cost of 10 soaps equals to rupees 9 into 10. As you can see in this statement, as the number of soaps increase, the amount also increase. Okay, rupees 9 into 10. So we get the answer rupees 9. Therefore, cost of 10 soaps equals to rupees 90. So students, in this way you have to solve question number 1. Now let us move to next question. Okay students, now let us move to question number 4. A car uses 30 liters of petrol to cover a distance of 375 km. 30 liters of petrol is used to cover a distance of 375 km. How many liters of petrol will it use to cover a distance of 1200 km? So students, by reading this question we can understand, if the kilometer is increased, the consumption of petrol will also be increased. Okay, if the kilometer is decreased, the consumption of petrol will also be decreased. Now let us solve this question. As you can see clearly, petrol used by a car to cover 375 km equals to 30 liters. Okay. Now we have to find that petrol used by a car to cover 1 km equals to 30 by 375 liters. Okay. Now what we have to find? Petrol used by a car to cover 1200 km equals to 30 by 375 into 1200. Okay, because petrol used by a car to cover 1 km equals to this much, so petrol used by a car to cover 1200 km equals to 30 by 375 into 1200. On simplification, we get the answer 96. Okay, as you can see clearly, I have simplified here. You can simplify this in your method also. Okay. So our final answer will be 96 liters. So therefore you can write, petrol used by the car to cover 1200 km equals to 96 liters. Okay students, so in this way you have to solve question number 4. Now let us move to another question. Okay students, now let us start क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, अजय अर्न्स रुपीज 10,680 इन 12 डेज, हाउ मच विल ही अर्न इन 18 डेज। सो बाय दिस क्वेश्चन वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट द अर्निंग ऑफ अजय इन 12 डेज इक्वल्स टू रुपीज 10,680। सो श्योरली द अर्निंग ऑफ अजय इन 18 डेज विल बी मोर देन द अर्निंग इन 12 डेज। So, to find the earning of Ajay in 18 days, first of all, we will find the earning of Ajay in 1 day. Money earned by Ajay in 12 days equals to rupees 10,680. Money earned by Ajay in 1 day, it will be lesser, equals to rupees 10,680 divided by 12. And we get the answer 890. This is income of Ajay in 1 day. Now we have to find the income of Ajay in 18 days. Money earned by Ajay in 18 days equals to rupees 890 into 18. So we get the answer rupees 16,020. Therefore, money earned by Ajay in 18 days equals to rupees 6,020. So students, I hope you all have understood all these three questions. Now other questions you have to solve by your own in your mathematics classwork copy. Okay, thank you and have a nice day ahead.